Milwaukee Journal Sentinel's Preps Plus is brought to you by Boston Store. Get your free 7-piece gift with any Clinique purchase of $27 or more. Shop in-store or online. And by Frederick and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, where sports medicine experts help athletes maximize their potential.
Hi, and welcome from Brookfield East High School. The great news, high school sports is back. It feels like football weather. I'm Lance Allen from today's TMJ4.
And I'm Mark Stewart, prep editor of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. Lance, buddy, did you miss me?
I certainly did. It's good to see you, Steve.
Good to see you, man. If you've been missing football, you'll get your fix tonight. We've got plenty of highlights on the way. But we're going to start the show by meeting a two-way standout from a team that expects to be much improved this season.
Mark, he's a guy that never goes on vacation. Brad Preter as our Boston Store featured student athlete.
Gun Zeke, fake 32, 4-4.
Jake Bennett is considered a leader here at Dominican High School. And he's had that reputation since he arrived as a freshman.
Even some of the upperclassmen at the time, they're like, you know, Jake, what are we running? What are we doing here, Jake? And he was just like a role model, I guess.
You know, I always try to be a servant leader. You know, I don't want to get in your face and yell at you. You know, I want to try to motivate you and try to get the best out of my teammates, you know. And thankfully, I have a great group of guys out here that are going to work hard, and I know they'll do their best.
Head coach Khris Middleton credits Jake with helping turn the program around by working both on and off the field. Jake has convinced other guys to go out for a team that had struggled to get enough players. Jake plays quarterback and middle linebacker for the Knights. While he may not catch every possible interception, Bennett was the Knights' leading tackler last season. He never came off the field except during kickoffs because his coach knows he makes plays.
You could see that after every game he was just hurting, but he always came and always got back up and started practicing on Monday. It's just a phenomenal will to win.
If you follow high school basketball closely, you may already know that Jake played on Dominican's state championship teams each of the past two seasons. While nobody's talking about football earning state championship rings like these, Jake wants to see Dominican's program earn more respect.
Dominican's more known for its theater program and its, you know, powerhouse basketball, but I truly believe that, you know, we're starting to change the culture here of football at Dominican, and you know, people are starting to respect us more, and I hope it just only continues to get bigger and bigger.
Last fall, with just 18 guys on the roster, Dominican went 2-7. There are more players this season, and hopefully more wins will follow. Regardless, Jake says he'll be having fun playing the game.
Out here on the football field, whether we're up 40, down 40, I'm always having fun. I'm giving it 100%. Football is a sport I just truly love.
While Jake has spent time convincing guys to join the football team, he also knows what it feels like to be on the other end of a conversation like that. This past spring, when the Dominican baseball team needed more players, those guys convinced Jake to join them on the diamond. In fact, Jake skipped playing AAU basketball so he could be part of the Knights baseball team.
It was definitely new for me. I wasn't the best on the team at all, but you know, I showed up, practice, work hard. Had a little injury issue with my shoulder, but I should return healthy and stuff for football. So I'm glad I went out and helped the school.
Jake isn't the only member of the Bennett family out here. His brother Bo, wearing number 7, is a freshman, and their dad is an assistant coach.
Jake's always very kind and helpful to Bo. It's always a learning curve your first freshman year, and particularly when you're at varsity, it's not easy. So it's really helpful to Bo, but I think Jake's enjoyed the fact that he's got his brother on the team as well.
You know, I get coaching at home and on the field, always giving me little tips and whatnot. It really helps me out. And my brother, you know, we're always competing out here because he's a quarterback as well, so we're always making each other better at practice. It's great to have him here at the Dominican.
1, 2, 3, nice!
Just like on the field, Jake is one of the leaders in the classroom. He's definitely one of the top students in his class.
Now it's time to hand out the first piece of hardware of the season, and here's Colleen Hyder from Boston Store to do the honors.
For everything you do in your community and for your team, Boston Store is proud to present you with the Preps Plus Student Athlete of the Week Award. Congratulations.
All right, Jake. Yay!
Whether you're up with the sun or down with a good workout,
or somewhere in between. No matter how active your life is, Boston Store has great styles, brands, and prices to fit whatever and however you choose to live active. So get out there, live active. Boston Store.
You can run.
You can eat right.
You can join a club.
You can get a checkup.
Of all the decisions you make to stay healthy, one decision can make it all possible. Choosing the Freidert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network as your partner. We have the providers you need in locations close to you, all connected to one of the nation's leading academic medical centers. Learn how to be stronger together with us at Freidert.com/onedecision.
Back at Brookfield East High School on Preps Plus, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel's high school sports show. Lance, it's the first week of the high school football season, and there were plenty of intriguing matchups.
Mark, it was definitely tough to narrow down the games, but here are a few that we chose to cover. Roll the Preps Plus highlights.
It's a season of transition for Wisconsin Lutheran. Longtime coach Kirk DeNoyer is gone. Assistant Joel Radue takes over, and he has quite a challenge in his first game. Greater Metro Conference power, Marquette. Down 6-0, the Viking D makes a play. Ian Wirtz with the pick, and Wisco is in business. Later, it's Josh Kren punching it in, and we are even at 6. On to the second quarter, and we get a barrage of points. First, it's Marquette quarterback Jack Dwyer with a perfect strike to Michael Duffy. Toppers up 12-6, but the Vikings answer that one in a hurry. On the ensuing kickoff, it's Kren one more time. He finds a seam, and he will go all the way, 92 yards in all. Wisconsin Lutheran jumps on top 13-12. No problem for the Toppers. Two plays later, Dwyer with the pump fake and Daniel Reardon with the acrobatic catch. This covers 64 yards in all. Marquette ahead to stay up 19-13. And before half, the Toppers add to that lead. Gerard Swan goes right up the gut. Marquette on their way up 26-13. We get more Dwyer and Swan in the third. Jack with the toss and Gerard is in stride. Toppers now up by 20. Dwyer caps his 278-yard, 5-touchdown night with this quick out to Duffy, who takes it in. It was exhausting for this guy, but Marquette was impressive in a 40-13 victory.
It was a good start. We've still got some things to work on, but I think throughout the summer we've been gelling together as a team, so when it came to game time, we were ready.
Welcome to the west side of Wauwatosa for the crosstown matchup between Tosa East and Tosa West. You know, it's still hard to believe that these longtime rivals went 15 years without playing each other. But since the rivalry was renewed in 2011, Tosa West has won two of the three matchups. A third straight win in the series would be a great springboard for the Trojans into what they hope is a playoff run in 2015. Before the game, Tosa coming together at midfield to cut the ribbon on the new field turf at West Stadium, which ironically gave Tosa East a friendly bounce on the first play of the game, as Jake Horonic forces the fumble that the Red Raiders are lucky to recover. Tosa East punts, and West marches the length of the field. Rayvon Bartlett rolling out finds 6'3" Javari Jackson. 17 yards for the first touchdown of the season, it's 7-0. But the Red Raider defense keeping them in the game. Second quarter, Jackson, under all sorts of pressure, is sacked by Tayshawn Crate. 7-0 West going to halftime. The story of the game was the Tosa West defense. They allowed just 54 total yards to Tosa East. Javari Jackson also with 2 sacks on the night. Late in the third quarter, West puts it away. Kobe Vines rushed for 136 yards. Bartlett sneaks it in for the score as West pitches a shutout. 17-0 winners over Tosa East. The sword stays with the Trojans, bragging rights retained for another year.
Our kids look forward to this game. We don't really talk about it much in the offseason. They know what's at stake. I know what's at stake. And our kids were dialed in, and that was the result tonight. They've got the right attitude. They're coachable. They have positive attitude, and things are good here.
For the third consecutive season, Homestead and Arrowhead, two traditional football powers, squared off in an early season non-conference matchup.
Scott Babbler was on hand for the Preps Plus Game of the Week.
What a way to kick off the high school football season. Two local powerhouses, Arrowhead and Homestead, are meeting for the third consecutive year. The Highlanders won the first two matchups, but the Warhawks are looking for a bitter revenge here in 2015. Arrowhead was the state D1 runner-up last season after back-to-back championships, and they were a motivated crew tonight. First quarter, senior QB Johnny Duranzo with a nice spin move, picking up the first down. Later, he calls his own number once again and wins the race to the end zone. The Warhawks jump on top 7-0. The Highlanders respond in the second. Eric Zeller across the middle to Patrick Minkin for a first down. Later in the drive on a fourth and goal, it's Zeller on the keeper, and we are all even at 7 apiece. But the Warhawks answer before half thanks to Nick Bastine. The senior does it all on this drive. First, a leaping grab for a big gain. Then he pops through the middle and maneuvers 15 yards for another first down. Finally, he caps the drive with this sweep for an easy score, 14-7 Arrowhead at halftime. And Bastine keeps it going in the third. He goes up the gut and he is gone. A 72-yard score. Nick ran for 140 on the night. The team ran for over 300 yards. Warhawks up a couple scores. They went to the air with success as well. Here, Duranzo finds Justin Parrott from 7 yards out. Arrowhead gets some payback with a 28-14 win over Homestead.
Yeah, there's a lot of motivation. I mean, we have a lot of kids that were on the team the past couple years that lost to the Homestead team the past year. So, I mean, we wanted to get back at them, get back that W.
Oh yeah, you know, we always want to win. You know, we had a good game plan coming in, it was great. I thought I could have played better, but you know, we got the W. Nick Bastine had a big game, our offensive line played great.
You learned so much about yourself. Again, the last 2 years, we've learned so much about ourselves in losses to Homestead. They've been integral in our development. And I hope that we continue to learn from a win too.
We're gonna go back and look at the film. We're gonna find out where our weaknesses are. There's a few that we had tonight, and we'll clean them up and we'll get better from this. We'll learn and be a better football team next week.
Hi, I'm J.R. Radcliffe, sports director for Lake Country Publications and Now Newspapers. Check out our central hub for all things high school football, Push for the Playoffs, where you can find weekly updated content, including our player of the week, notes on all area teams, updates on past players, rankings, standings, and more. Visit mycommunitynow.com/push. And in the meantime, follow Preps Plus on social media. Preps Plus will be right back.
What if, instead of having one cancer doctor, you had a team of specialists looking at you from every angle? That's what Frederd and the Medical College of Wisconsin's Cancer Network gives you. Researchers, surgeons, chemotherapy, radiation, and genetic experts. Every point of view, getting you the right diagnosis right away. Giving you more options, involving you in every decision, and turning what ifs into what is possible.
Whether you're up with the sun, or down with a good workout, or somewhere in between, no matter how active your life is, Boston Store has great styles, brands, and prices to fit whatever and however you choose to live active. So get out there, live active. Boston Store.
In two seasons with the Milwaukee Bucks, Khris Middleton has established himself as a reliable performer on the court.
Middleton signed a big new contract last month. He's our guest in tonight's edition of From Preps to Pros.
I was a kid, I just liked to go outside and play sports.
I didn't play football growing up, but I like to play baseball a lot, definitely basketball.
James Christian Middleton, who goes by Khris, is a sports guy through and through. Khris was a pitcher and shortstop in baseball growing up, and at a young age essentially chose his profession.
I played until I was about 13. I had to make a decision whether it was AAU basketball or baseball, and I chose AAU basketball at the time.
Khris gives a lot of credit to his parents, who have always been supportive.
I've seen that they worked hard for me growing up, putting me in positions where I could play and just do what I wanted. It's definitely kept me going since, even to this day.
In his senior year of high school, Middleton averaged 22.4 points and 8.6 rebounds per game and took his team to state. He was ranked 64th best prospect by ESPN in 2009 before choosing to play at Texas A&M, which is where he says being a professional starts.
To be professional, definitely first comes with school. Got to be have good grades, first of all. Then also just enjoy what you're doing with sport. You got to love the game if you want to be a professional. I ain't even love it. Just got to have love for the game and want to play it at all times, anytime you can.
Middleton came to the Bucks in 2013 on a trade from the Detroit Pistons. He played all 82 games his first year with the Bucks and had 64 starts. In his second year, during a matchup with the Phoenix Suns on December 15, 2014, Middleton hit a three-point buzzer beater, lifting the Bucks to their 13th win of the 2014-15 season.
That's a lot of excitement. We have a great young team that's made a lot of improvements since last year, so it's exciting right here. Guys are having fun. We're learning the game, competing every game, which is good.
Last fall, Arrowhead's girls tennis team won their first state championship. This year, half the Warhawks lineup will be new, but expectations remain high.
We now present our Preps Plus Team of the Week.
Every new season should bring with it a lot of fun and excitement. But Arrowhead girls tennis had something else to enjoy when the season started. For the first time, the Warhawks hold the title of defending state champions.
It was really cool. Everybody in school knew. It was fun to put the banner on the gym.
We had a fantastic season last year, and it was really fun to, you know, finally have some like recognition for the tennis team.
Last season, the Warhawks dominated opponents on their way to winning the WIAA State Team Tournament. When practice started this season, the girls knew they'd have to replace their graduated seniors, who made up half of that state title squad.
When we showed up, Coach was just looking for people to fill the spots. She was looking for people to work hard and to really step it up to fill in the shoes of the girls that left.
Off-season training for the girls included lessons, USTA matches, tennis camp, and playing matches on their own.
I know a lot of the girls do other sports the other seasons, but I know that they spend a lot of time practicing the off-season, especially in the summer.
The first week of practice consisted of tryouts, with the girls competing for which flight they'd played this season, but it appeared to be a friendly competition.
We all realize that everyone has a role to play, everyone's equally important, and we just want to be the best team we can be, and everyone cheers for each other, everyone supports each other. We're a very close team.
Just spending time with each other outside of tennis, just to become like more comfortable personally with each other, and I think that really helps throughout the year with just like team dynamic and just always being there to motivate each other and support each other.
They've seen how important it is as a team. And what a cool feeling that is to win as a team. I mean, individual, we'll get a lot of girls there, which is awesome. But the goal has always been team state.
Arrowhead has 80 girls out for tennis this season, and Coach Gina Resch says they'll all get to compete at some level. As for the varsity, Resch is really hoping the Warhawks can get back to team state again and repeat that title. She had to stay home last fall because she had a baby during the state individual tournament, then had to stay home during the team tourney the following week.
I wanted to be there so badly. It was, obviously the baby came first, but if I could have taken a six-day-old baby to the Madison Nielsen State Tennis Tournament, then I probably would have. So yeah, I'd love to get back there because I want to be on that court jumping up and down, celebrating. The girls just have to play the best that they can, and I'll be happy with anything. As long as they give it their all every time they're out there, how can you be disappointed? That's all a coach can hope for.
Best of luck this season to the Arrowhead Warhawks, our Preps Plus Team of the Week.
Every year, Preps Plus teams with Boston Store to present a pair of college scholarships.
Let's meet this year's Boston Store Preps Plus scholarship winners.
Kim, on behalf of Preps Plus and Boston Store, congratulations on winning the $1,000 scholarship.
Thank you.
Life in the United States was challenging for Kim Mai after her family moved here a few years ago. Learning to understand and speak English made school difficult, but Kim persevered and became one of the top students in her class.
The first time and they speak, I don't understand. Yeah, after that, and my teacher and my cousin and my parents say, and that's okay, and you can speak, and yeah, and in the class, and I speak, and so I understand a little bit, and now I can speak English.
Rory Cerny also had to make an adjustment during high school. Cerny could no longer play football, his favorite sport, after suffering a fractured spine. Since he couldn't be on the field, Rory devoted his time and energy to being an excellent student and volunteering at churches and food pantries.
It's a big commitment here. You spend a lot of hours doing it, but it really, like, you see the people that you help and they're very grateful.
Both Rory and Kim will be using their scholarships as they study at UW-Milwaukee.
Whether you're up with the sun, or down with a good workout, or somewhere in between, no matter how active your life is, Boston Store has great styles, brands, and prices to fit whatever and however you choose to live active. So get out there, live active. Boston Store.
You can run.
You can eat right.
You can join a club.
You can get a checkup.
Of all the decisions you make to stay healthy, one decision can make it all possible. Choosing the Freidert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network as your partner. We have the providers you need in locations close to you, all connected to one of the nation's leading academic medical centers. Learn how to be stronger together with us at freidert.com/onedecision.
The ACL is the anterior cruciate ligament. It's one of the four major ligaments in the knee. It prevents rotational instability of the knee. Females playing basketball and soccer are 7 to 9 times more likely to tear their ACL than a male playing the same sport. Really, the only way an athlete can prevent an ACL injury is to go through a strength training program. That program needs to incorporate strengthening of the hamstrings, training the hamstrings to fire more quickly. That program also needs to incorporate jump training. The goal is to prevent the athlete from landing from a jump in a position that puts their knee at risk. We want to prevent that rotational injury to the knee. The recommended treatment for an ACL injury in a high school athlete is going to be reconstructive surgery. Athletes can get back to their sport in 6 to 8 months.
For more information, visit freidert.com/sports.
Last season, Nicolet High School had to cancel its varsity football season due to a lack of players.
This year, the Knights program is back and the numbers are way up. Scott Babbler's got the Preps Plus spotlight.
The hot grind of August practice pays off on autumn Friday nights as these athletes bask in the glory of the high school football experience. But faced with a manpower shortage, Nicolet had to pass on having a varsity team last season.
When it first happened, obviously everyone who was there was disappointed, but you know, you take a step back, you look at the bigger picture, and you realize that's what we needed as a program to build us up for the next coming years.
The process had to play out. We knew that we had a strong group of sophomores and juniors, and we knew that we needed them to develop at a correct rate, and that was at the JV level. Forcing them to play varsity before they were ready to play would not have been a good move.
What the Knights did was field a JV squad with very promising results, a 10-2 record, and a ton of positives. Besides the wins, it was a great bonding experience for the underclassmen.
That junior and sophomore class were able to kind of merge earlier than they would have. Normally that would happen this year, but they got a head start on it last year because they were kind of that, they were kind of thrown together in a tough situation and had to thrive on some adversity, and then found, hey, we're working hard, we're thriving together, we're having success on the field, we like each other. And so in some ways that was maybe a blessing in disguise.
It allowed us as a team to, for the juniors, now seniors, to get to know the sophomores who are now going to be upperclassmen with us. It allowed us to mesh on the JV level, get a little more experience under our belt, so then this coming year, we're ready to go on the varsity level.
What happened last year was, I think a lot of the kids that played on the JV team really, really said, hey, you know, let's take upon ourselves, let's never let this happen again. Let's talk to other kids and tell them how important it is to get out for football and show them that we can do this. And I think by having success on the field and then being able to convince some of the other kids in the school that, hey, we can do this, I think that ended up getting some other kids to come out and the numbers were strong.
To further solidify the Knights for their varsity return, the players and coaches spent their first week of practice at UW-Oshkosh.
We got a little taste of, like, we stayed in the dorms, we got a little taste of the college life, and we had practices every day, and I think that we were all excited. We were all gearing up and getting ready.
We got to practice like on their field, and we got to stay in the dorms, and we got to just, it was really good to bond with our teammates and our coaches.
You know, you just spend all that time together, you get to know people, you get practice time, meeting time, fun time. It was a really good experience, yeah.
Due in part to last season, the Knights have not won a varsity football game since September of 2012. The players would like to end that streak in a hurry, but they have much bigger goals.
Between the players, we've been talking, you know, it's been since 1989 that we last made the playoffs, and that's our goal for this year. It's a big step, but we definitely know we can do it.
Certainly our goal is to win every Friday night. That's a tough goal. We play in a very difficult conference. There's a lot of good teams, a lot of tremendous coaches, but that's our goal, is to get out and be competitive and try to win every time we go out there.
Victory number one for all involved, the feeling of being back on the football field on a fall Friday night.
Thanks for joining us tonight.
You can watch Preps Plus each and every Sunday night at 11 o'clock right here on today's TMJ4. I'm Lance Allen.
And I'm Mark Stewart. We'll see you next week on Preps Plus.
The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel's Preps Plus is brought to you by Boston Store. Get your free 7-piece gift with any Clinique purchase of $27 or more. Shop in-store or online. And by Frederick and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, where sports medicine experts help athletes maximize their potential.